Hello, I'm Bill Simon. I'm a CPA with the firm of W.H. Simon & Company. We have been in practice for almost 30 years representing people before the Internal Revenue Service throughout the country, and as well as some international work that we do, quite a bit of it. One of the issues I want to talk with you about today is employment tax. And specifically, I want to speak to the issue of misclassification of workers. It's a very common practice in small business and even in larger businesses to classify workers as independent contractors. Why? Because you save on employment tax, you save on workman's comp insurance, you save on unemployment insurance, you save on fringe benefits. All of these savings add up and end up as a bottom line in your business. However, the misclassification of workers has been around for a long time, and it's a problem that IRS has continually attempted to address. But as of recent, with the budget cuts that IRS has experienced, they've looked at certain programs, this being one of them, to say, how can we generate more revenue for the government with the programs we have on the books? And this is that program. This is one of three areas that they are really concentrating on. And to that extent, they have joined forces with three different agencies, IRS, the Department of Labor, and the Criminal Division of the Justice Department. You say criminal, criminal. Because many times this misclassification can be a criminal matter. It can be a situation where you and the worker conspire to accomplish the non-payment of employment taxes. I'm going to set that issue aside, but it's lurking out there in the weeds, so to speak. You need to be aware of it. But let's talk about the civil side of this. Let's talk about the money that's involved here. First of all, if you misclassify a worker and you say, okay, I have a contract, that's always the answer we get. Well, I have a signed contract from this worker saying he knows he's an independent contractor and he knows that he's responsible for his payroll taxes. And he does not look to us for workman's compensation coverage. Okay? That sounds good. But in most cases, it's not worth the paper it's written on because IRS, the Department of Labor, are going to look beyond that contract to see what is the relationship with that worker. They're going to look to see what you provide the worker, what does the worker provide to this business arrangement, does the worker have a chance to make money and lose money, or just to make money by working for a per job fee or per hour fee. Is that a business arrangement? Does every business open up with the idea I can only make money, I can't lose money? I don't think so. And that's the kind of thing they look at. Do you have the opportunity to tell that worker, I don't want to use you on this job, I want to use your buddy on this job? Or are you locked into using that worker? Or can the worker turn around and do the same thing with you and say, look, I'm not going to go out and lay the brick on this job. I'm going to send my brother out to lay the brick on this job. Is that acceptable under your relationship? Most likely not, because you're looking for the skill set that that worker has. So you have to look at the relationship, and those are the things that IRS looks at. Now, if you misclassify the worker, here's your problem. First of all, you're going to incur employment taxes for these workers with penalties and interest. Two, you're going to have to provide fringe benefits to these workers or put your fringe benefit program for all of your employees, including yourself, in jeopardy. Three, you're going to have to provide, in addition to standard fringe benefits under the new health care laws, you're going to have to provide health care coverage or be penalized for not doing so. And if you have a retirement plan, you're going to have to provide those benefits to the worker, or put your program in jeopardy and all your employees in jeopardy. It's a serious situation. IRS has certain relief provisions that if you have been misclassifying workers, that you can gain relief on some of these areas. It's critical that you understand what the relief is and what can be done and how it's done to properly protect yourself as well as you can. This is critical. Keep in mind, IRS has identified this as one of their top level targets, and they have a system where they're tracking, one, the number of 1099s that a business is filing and the amount of money that's reported on those 1099s in relation to the business that they're running and the wages that they're paying through the normal employment tax situation. And they have statistics that show which businesses are conducive to really independent contractors and which aren't. Keep that in mind. If you need assistance and advice in this area, I strongly urge you to call us, set up an appointment, let us go through your situation, let us provide you with some alternatives and some advice. And this will be done at no cost to you. Free consultation, we'll be happy to spend some time with you and go through it and help you with this area. Thank you very much. Please feel free to contact us at the number listed below.